Heavyweight Division, introducing, in the red corner, fighting out of Chicago, Illinois, weighing 217 pounds, he is rated number 4 by the WBA, here is James Quick Tillis. And in the blue corner, from Warren, Ohio, weighing 209 and one half pounds, the veteran and hard-hitting Ernie Shavers. 10 rounds of boxing.
Ernie, of course, who had retinal surgery performed by Dr. Ron Michaels, the same type of surgery by the same surgeon as that which Sugar Ray Leonard recently underwent. Most people felt Shavers should not have come back from that surgery, and indeed he looked finished when Bernardo Mercado beat him shortly after the Lake Placid Winter Olympics in 80 at Great Gorge, New Jersey. But he is back, and he is back because he needs it. Obviously. The action begins in round one. Boswell living by WBC rules, 10-point must scoring system, three judges score. Referee, no voice in the scoring. The three knockdown rule is in effect. A mandatory eight count. No standing eight count allowed. No saving by the bell, except of course the 15th round, which concludes the fight. Thing to watch in Tillis is the quickness of movement. He is quick-handed, quick-footed fighter. He's only lost once. 21-1-0. With 17 KOs. The opponent's not noteworthy. He did fight for the WBA version of the crown, lost a 15-round decision to Mike Weaver. Good, quick combination a few seconds back, landed by Tillis. The right against the left side of Shaver's face, jarring Ernie a bit. Ernie stalking. Great power puncher, as you know. Back in 77, in the early going, in New York, he hurt the then champion Muhammad Ali. Referee in the bout is Joey Curtis. Ernie trying to work over the midsection. The three judges, all Nevadans. Chuck Minker, Herb Santos, he's from Reno, the others from Las Vegas, and Lou Tappet. A million names on the Vegas boxing scene. Ernie was covering well there against Tillis. We have less than a minute to go in round one.
Nice and clean.
Joey Curtis breaking them up, telling Ernie no hitting on the break. Interestingly, working in Jim Tillis's corner, Angelo Dundee. Quick hand scoring left and the right against Shavers by Tillis. Morning, Dundee said, you watch Jim, he will give Shavers a boxing lesson. End of round one approaching.
The bucket.
Tillis. Ready for the start of round two. Jim Quick Tillis boxing neatly in round one. Using the ring, lots of steady foot movement and the quick hand speed scoring as he outboxed Ernie in the first round. Now in round two, you can look for more of same. Ernie trying to pull his way in, working where he can to the midsection. Dundee between rounds telling Tillis, don't give him a shot. Just keep boxing, keep your distance the way you have been. Ernie trying to pinion Tillis against the ropes. Tillis is quick, flashing left, getting into Ernie's face. Every time that low registers in the face, I worry about the odds. People are telling Sugar Ray Leonard he must never fight again. What about a man Ernie's age, listed as 37? What about a man who's been through all of the ups and downs of life itself, not just in the ring, but outside the ring? Trying to cover, Tillis trying to score points. And he is, from time to time, doing just that, scoring points. Right there, a right lead. Notice Ernie unable to get through Tillis. See the quick hands, quick counter-punching combination by Tillis. Connecting with a right. Another right by Ernie scored and hurt Tillis a little. But the action has been dominated by the boxing skills of James Quick Tillis. Well, watch this. This was after the bell. You see that right? It scored. But that right jawed Tillis. He was groggy. He staggered to his corner. And the net result was Dundee ran over the referee, Joey Curtis. Dundee is checking his fighter, James Quick Tillis, now. But the right that staggered Tillis definitely landed after the bell. Now, what impact will that have on Tillis's maneuverability? How quick are his recuperative powers? No question, he was hurt seriously by an after the bell blow. The round had been won, in my view, rather easily by Tillis, though in the final 30 seconds Chavis connected with two rights. But then came the after the bell right. Look, Tillis is still. Good right by Chavis, another. He has Tillis hurt. Tillis seeking to hold on. Chavis rights and now connecting with Tillis. That overhand looping right comes over Tillis's left now and scores. And the hurt is etched in Tillis's eyes. Look at Tillis try and hold on. So suddenly, some old-style Ernie Chavis punching power. looking to land the big blow. Dundee screaming, move away, move, stick to the battle plan so carefully constructed. Don't look to get your own shots in, look to score points. That's what Dundee is telling him, and Tillis there responds. Notice on defense, Tillis is beginning to drop his hands some. You'll see both hands occasionally now down by the body. Ernie resorting to mauling and brawling now. Boss, there's always the question of stamina with Shavers. He's got to put his man away early on balance to win. His most recent fight, he's taking a point away from Shavers for hitting low. Ernie's most recent fight, a controversial second round TKO of Joe Buckley, the British. We have 20, 35 seconds left in this, the third round. And after hurting Tillis early in the round, Shavers, who looks suddenly fatigued, and it's only the third round, Shavers has been outboxed by Tillis. Right there you see Tillis scoring again.
Yourself, okay?
He's right there for you.
Take a deep breath.
Keep them combinations going. That's where to get it.
Once more.
There we go. But get the wire right here. Keep together.
Throw that right hand straight in. Hit him on this one side. Throw that combination. You'll be all right.
Round four getting underway. Dundee working over his man Tillis in the corner between rounds, putting his hands up in front of his face and saying, keep that guard up, keep it up there. Keep your distance, stay out of range of Ernie's right, which has been Ernie's only real weapon thus far. Quickly, Tillis scores with his fast hands. Looping overhand right has been Ernie's weapon. Of course, it reached maximum effectiveness when it was delivered after the bell, and Tillis was a sitting duck for it. That came after the second round bell. Ernie stunned by Tillis, just covering now against the ropes, and remember, this ring now is registered at 108 degrees. The desert heat, what impact it must have on a man Shaver's age. Ernie now throwing blows only occasionally. The head snapped by a quick right just seconds ago. Tillis has recovered from the time he was staggered. He is using his feet well. That's what Tillis must not do. Allow himself to be hauled against the ropes and not have the movement to escape Shaver's overhand right. Tillis working with nice effectiveness in this, the fourth round. Left keeps getting in. scored with four lefts in that recent, not even exchange. Blood coming from the left nostril of Ernie Chavez now.
Bring it up there, over the top, over that left.
So Tillis's constant left beginning to take physical effect on Chavez. 20 seconds left in round four, a round easily dominated by James Quick Tillis. Beautifully constructed young man. Look at Chavez just in the corner, taking it, trying to cover. And then suddenly, the right, and another right, and Tillis is hurt. This time it was before the bell. Tillis completely, easily dominating the round, and then suddenly, that right of Chavez, the long overhand right. Tillis staggered, and then still another right as the bell sounded. Jimmy did not go down, but he fell against the ropes. Dundee slapping Tillis in the corner. Tillis, his legs were up in front of him. Dundee slapped both knees and said, stretch those legs, kid, stretch them. Now they're exhorting Tillis to fight his fight and not to get careless. Saw in slow motion what Chavez did. Chavez sitting there in the corner, they patched up his left nostril. Chavez relying on that big overhand right, hoping for a knockout. And he has the punching power to execute same at any time. This is round five.
Take your time. Set him up, Ernie. Come on.
While Ernie keeps looking for the opportunity for the right, he keeps absorbing punishment that manifested itself in the bloodied nose last round. That's been patched up for the moment at least. And Tillis keeps scoring points. Look at Tillis's foot movement there. Moving target. The other thing Dundee's been telling Tillis, keep moving. Stay on your toes and use that ring. The ring, of course, 20 by 20. Good size ring. Chavez, first time, he was actually stunned by it. Seconds earlier, Chavez was mauling and brawling with Tillis. Crowd roared, but it was not at that point effective. Right scored, Chavez right. Ernie trying to go all over him now. Pulling him against the ropes. We have a minute left in the fifth round. On the break, Chavez scored with a right. On the break, Joey Curtis warning Chavez. A point was taken away from Chavez in round three. Tillis left as Chavez came charging in. Went right into Tillis's left against the chest, which scored. Ernie desperately trying to connect with the overhand right. And just above us, along the ropes, Ernie did connect with the right, but Tillis responded.
Keep him shot, Ernie! Keep him shot!
which eye, ask Wallow if he remembers which eye had the retinal surgery. Shavers in his corner waiting for the bell for the start of round six, and there it is. This has not been a scintillating fight. For Shavers, fighting is basically a memory and seeking to land the overhand right to knock out an opponent if he can very quickly. But Ernie has nowhere to go in boxing. And he is such a fine fellow, has such good character. You hate to see him risk possible loss of sight. Earlier we discussed the retinal surgery he underwent, microsurgery it is called technically, performed by the now noted specialist of the Wilmer Eye Institute at Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore, Maryland, Dr. Ron Michael. Sugar Ray Leonard, who is here, by the way, and whose eye shows visible and steady improvement, his healing process coming along nicely. Sugar Ray now views Dr. Michaels as his personal hero. This is round six. The action, such as it has been, has clearly slowed. Gillis moving, staying out of range. Yeah. That's a terrible fight. Oh. Ernie Shavers in his corner being worked over prior to the advent of round seven. Ernie Shavers, whose left eye is already swollen. Such a worrisome thing. It was the left eye that underwent the retinal surgery. Surgery for a detached retina. And Gillis has scored enough points with his quick hands and his boxing effectiveness to have caused first blood to flow from the left nostril, and now the left eye swells. And always there is the worry deep in the minds of those watch and care in one blow cause the retina to become detached again. wonder why athletic commissions don't simply invoke the law. Not invoke, pass a law or a rule not allowing men to fight after having suffered detached retinas. Lloyd Patterson, member now of the New York State Athletic Commission, has been notable in his fight for the thumbless glove. Dr. Edwin Campbell, chief medical advisor of the New York State Athletic Commission, says that 98% of all fighters' eye injuries come from a thumb in the eye. This fight is following the pattern of prior rounds. Ernie, visibly tired, still dreaming of landing an overhand right that can knock out the opponent. And one must never discount it. This is the seventh round. You remember Ernie's fight here in Las Vegas against Larry Holmes? It was the seventh round, and he had Holmes. He floored him, and Holmes was groggy, could barely stand when he got up. But that was when Ernie's eye was terribly damaged, and Holmes, at that point in time, had great recuperative powers, reassumed command of the fight nicely enough, and it was stopped in the 11th in Holmes' favor. Joey Curtis, the referee. It's another point to be made. You wonder why, when heavyweights are fighting, they put in a smallish man to serve as referee. The man must be big enough and strong enough to be able to break these men, to dominate them, not only with his verbal orders, but if need be, with his physical prowess. Right there, he's having trouble breaking. Good point. Pour in some soda for me, please. Soda. Yeah. Ringside in a 32,000 seat makeshift arena in Las Vegas, Nevada. Round 8 is about to start. Round 7 of a pattern with prior rounds. Tillis's quick hands and boxing skills dominating Chavis. Chavis just had his head snapped upwards by a Tillis left to the chin, and another, and another. He doubled up and scored both times, and another. Chavis, after the bell in the second round, almost floored Tillis. It was an illegal punch. In the third round, he did score twice with overhand rights, hurt Tillis once, but there have been no knockdowns, and Tillis has atoned for those lapses by completely outboxing Chavis. See for yourselves. His gloves steadily in Chavis' face. Some are picked off, like that one. On balance, he's mostly getting through. Now, what have we here?
Let him fight. Let him fight. Throw more punches, will you?
But next to Ernie's right eye, immediately Joey Curtis. Ernie's back had been to us, but we hadn't thus been able to see the cut. But the minute his right eye was cut, Joey Curtis did the wise thing, went over to the ring doctor. Maybe now you can see the cut. It is beneath the corner of the right eye. So there'll be no loss of vision problem.
I want you to break it even.
Since it's below the eye. But it is, again, visible evidence of how Tillis has been scoring. His boxing skills, quickness of that left jab with increasing frequency. Now when Ernie throws the overhand right, it is laboriously. It seems to take forever to get to the intended target. And by that time, of course, Tillis is gone. Eighth round action. And you hate to see it. Unless there's a miracle. Tillis will have won an easy decision. And you wonder how long Ernie can continue to fight and should. Figures he needs to be peppered. Working over Ernie Shaver's right eye, the cut beneath the corner of that right eye. The eye itself is now swelling. The left eye, the one that underwent retinal surgery, already swollen. It's round nine, and Tillis is having a boxing exhibition for himself. Interesting aspect of this fight may have been Angelo Dundee working Tillis's corner. Aggressive, more so, more vocal than I have ever seen him before. Trying to goad his fighter in the manner of maybe Bobby Knight, Indiana basketball. A lot of blood on Tillis's pants. It's Shaver's blood. Tillis is uncut, unmarked. See that left get in there? He doubled on it, got them both in. Shaver's tried with the right, but the snap is no longer there, seemingly. Shaver's desperate. And it's sad to see. Ernie is now just trying to push the opponent against the ropes, somehow score with the right. Saw the wild right over the shoulder and behind the head. Not any evidence of boxing skills. There was the wild roundhouse right, and he got him. He got him, and Tillis may be gone. We said, maybe a miracle. What is this? Tillis jumped up to his feet immediately. When it looked like he may be gone, he jumped to his feet. The first knockdown of the fight. Shaver scored again with the right. Wild roundhouse right. An amateur should be able to get away from a blow like that. And Joey Curtis, the undersized referee, can't separate them. Joey himself has a belly. He's out of shape, covered with sweat, 108 degree temperature in the ring. Tillis is groggy, the legs are rubbery, Chavis senses it. Out of nowhere in the ninth round, looking simply terrible. Chavis at one point, falling halfway over the ropes. After missing a wild right, he floors it. Well, look at that knockdown again. A big round, Bernie, there's the right. That was it, and he was hurt. One thing you have noticed in this fight, Tillis is easily hurt. He went down late on his stomach, his head to the canvas. There it is again, that wild roundhouse overhand right. And look at it. It didn't appear that he could possibly rise. He lay there that way. The referee, Joey Curtis, deserves a look. He looks more battered than the fighters. This is the 10th and final round. Tillis back to his boxing style, pushing off on Chavis there. He didn't push off last round. He got careless. He thought he had things well in hand. And he is susceptible, we have discovered, very easily to punishment. Series of combinations, scoring heavily for Jim Tillis. We are 50 seconds into the final round. Chavis still looking to connect with the round. And Tillis scores with the right three times, four times. Now pushing Chavis off. Chavis' right eye has become a bloody mess, over as well as under where the cut originally was. Ernie trying to draw upon some final physical resource, namely that overhand right or that wild roundhouse right. But Tillis is scoring very effectively in this round with his left and right, the left jab again and again, the right combination, sometimes the right alone. Through four consecutive rights that scored on Chavis earlier in the round. Blood again from Ernie's left nostril. You people at home can see that this is not heavyweight quality class. Ernie ready to go down there. Hit by a left and a right. A wide open target. And this time, Tillis, following Dundee's instructions, has been pushing off the opponent. And he has been scoring at will. Now it's Tillis who's using his body. And he's doing it effectively. We have 30 seconds left in the fight. So the fight has gone the distance. Ernie is dead tired. Fight is winding down, and Ernie has to be just as happy as it is. Look at Ernie. Fell against the ropes as the fight ended. So, we await the decision. When? It's a disgrace. This fight's a disgrace. Phyllis is terrible. Phyllis can't take a blow.
Yeah, I'm on. Hey, Chuck. See how stupid it is to have Lane as the referee of the big fight? A little man, they can't handle it. I'm going to concentrate on that. And we come on. The heat and that. He cost Shavers the fight, this referee. Wasn't strong enough. And Mills Lane is even smaller. Doing a heavyweight fight.
On with my jacket, Woody.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision. Judge Herb Santo score 96-92. Judge Chuck Minker score 97-91.
Woody, would you give me a hand?
And Judge Lou Tevis score 96-92 for the winner by unanimous decision, James.
I mean, hey. Isn't that stupid?
Hey, what the hell are they looking at? I wonder.
I mean, that is so stupid.
Can't we sit? Yeah, I think so. Can you move this cable?
Working over Ernie Shaver's right eye, the cut beneath the corner of that right eye. The eye itself is now swelling. The left eye, the one that underwent retinal surgery, already swollen. It's round nine, and Gillis having a boxing exhibition for himself. Most interesting aspect of this fight may have been Angelo Dundee working Tillis's corner. Aggressive, more so, more vocal than I have ever seen him before. Trying to goad his fighter in the manner of maybe Bobby Knight, Indiana basketball.
Now for him! Now for him!
A lot of blood on Tillis's pants. It's Shaver's blood. Tillis is uncut, unmarked. See that left get in there? He doubled on it, got them both in. Shaver's tries with the right, but the snap is no longer there, seemingly. Shaver's desperate. And it's there to see.
Fucking
right.
Ernie is now just trying to push the opponent against the ropes, somehow score with the right. Saw the wild right over the shoulder and behind the head.
Put him together, come back with the hook on it.
Not any evidence of boxing skills. There was the wild roundhouse right, and he got him. He got him, and Tillis may be gone. We said, maybe a miracle. What is this? Tillis jumped up to his feet immediately. When it looked like he may be gone, he jumped to his feet. The first knockdown of the fight. Shaver scored again with a right. Wild roundhouse right. Amateur should be able to get away from a blow like that. And Joey Curtis, the undersized referee, can't separate them. Joey himself has a belly. He's out of shape, covered with sweat, 108-degree temperature in the ring.
Gillis is groggy. The legs are rubbery. Chavis senses it. Out of nowhere in the ninth round, looking simply terrible. Chavis at one point falling halfway over the ropes after missing a wild right. He flaws it. We'll look at that knockdown again. Big round for Ernie. There's the right. That was it, and he was hurt. One thing you have noticed in this fight, Gillis is easily hurt. He went down late on his stomach, his head to the canvas. There it is again, that wild roundhouse overhand right. And look at it. It didn't appear that he could possibly rise. He lay there that way. And then just as suddenly and quickly, he got up. Now Dundee, his face in Gillis's face, working his fighter over, trying to coerce him verbally to do that which he says. The referee, Joey Curtis, deserves a look. He looks more battered than the fighters. This is the 10th and final round. Gillis back to his boxing style, pushing off on Chavis there. He didn't push off last round. He got careless. He thought he had things well in hand. And he is susceptible, we have discovered, very easily to punishment. Series of combinations, scoring heavily with Jim Gillis. We are 50 seconds into the final round. Chavis still looking to connect with the right. And Gillis scores with the right three times, four times. Now pushing Chavis off. Chavis' right eye has become a bloody mess, over as well as under where the cut originally was. Ernie trying to draw upon some final physical resource, namely that overhand right or that wild roundhouse right. But Gillis is scoring very effectively in this round with his left and right, the left jab again and again, the right combination, and sometimes the right alone. Through four consecutive rights that scored on Chavis earlier in the round. Blood again from Ernie's left nostril. You people at home can see that this is not heavyweight quality class. Ernie ready to go down there, hit by a left and a right. A wide open target. This time, Gillis, following Dundee's instructions, has been pushing off the opponent, and he has been scoring at will. Now it's Gillis who's using his body, and he's doing it effectively. We have 30 seconds left in the fight. So the fight has gone the distance. Ernie is dead tired. Right is winding down, and Ernie has to be just as happy as it is. Look at Ernie. Fell against the ropes as the fight ends. So we await the decision. When? It's a disgrace. This fight's a disgrace. Gillis is terrible. Gillis can't take a blow.
Yeah, I'm on. Hey, Chet.
See how stupid it is to have Lane as the referee of the big fight? A little man, they can't handle it. I'm going to concentrate on that when we come on. The heat and that. He cost Shavers the fight, this referee. Wasn't strong enough, and Mills Lane is even smaller. Doing a heavyweight fight.
Will you help me on with my jacket, Woody?
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision. Oh. Judge Herb Santos scores 96-92. Judge Chuck Minter scores 97-91.
Woody, would you give me a
and
hand?
Judge Lou Deckard scores 96-92. For the winner by unanimous decision, James Quick.
How could they pull?
I mean, isn't that stupid?
Hey, what the hell are they looking at? I wonder.
I mean, that is so stupid.
Can't we?